Hello friends, welcome back to Power Query series. In the previous videos you have seen how to use the Power Query editor, the graphical user interface of Power Query, to shape up the data by using options, by clicking or right clicking to add a new column or a custom column in Excel as well as in Power BI. In this video I'm going to show you the same activity using the mQuery or M language, which is a functional language. We are not using clicks, but we are using coding to shape up the data the way we want. To begin with, I need to add a blank query. For that, I need to go to new option, new source, and select a blank query. Then a new query added. Let me name this query as revenue, because I am getting the revenue table from the same Excel file. Now I need to go to the advanced editor. In the advanced editor, there is a basic code, so I'm just changing the source, let and source, and then in source. That is what we discussed in the previous videos. So now only I need to change this portion. So where I need to get the data from Excel workbook, so the syntax will start like this: excel.workbook. Power Query Editor has got a nice IntelliSense interface, so that whenever you start typing, it will give you the option, so that it is not very hard work to understand. So only thing is, you need to practice it. By practice, you'll understand what you are going to do, but options are given as a menu or an IntelliSense menu. Dot workbook. Let me say dot workbook. Now, this workbook, I need to select the real workbook, including that whatever the location of the workbook. So that is basically the file. So file dot contents. Now in this, I need to give the path as a text. So within double quotes. So it is very specifically telling, please create a text. So any text should be in double quotes. So I've just copied the location, and then the name of the file is Power BI dashboard dot XLSX. Only thing is, I need to make sure that I'm typing the name properly. So this will actually takes the file only. So in the earlier video, if you have watched it carefully, there we selected the revenue table. So before that, what we did, we actually selected the Excel file. So that is what we are doing here. But this will not alone help us, because we need to go to the next level. That is, I need to select the revenue table. For that, I need to open a list. Within the list, I need to create the items. That is, item equal revenue, because I wanted to take the revenue table. So it should be carefully written, because it's case sensitive. The syntax is case sensitive. So the table name has to be written as it is. And then it is a kind of table. So kind equal table. And then this will actually give me the list of items, and only the table will be given. But from there, I need to extract the data. So for that, I need to write data. This is, I'm writing with my experience, but when I'm going to the basics, definitely I'll be able to make you understand each one, where I'm using a curly bracket, where I'm using a square bracket, where I'm using a normal bracket, where I'm using double quotes. All these things will be discussed in detail. But primarily, you need to understand the behavior and what are all we are using in the code, so that you'll be getting habituated, and then we will accordingly take care of. So in this video, we're majorly focusing on the functions. So this is the only step I've written, and just say done. Now you can see the data is flowing inside. Now you see the data is coming with the columns, and as we discussed in the earlier video, that registration number, customer, and date of joining have got a proper data type, including the student name as well. But student name is not really the student name. We are not focusing on that. We are focusing majorly on the errors and blanks and revenue column in this video. First of all, let me remove the errors. So I need to remove the errors from city and errors from sales rep. I'm following a small technique that wherever error is there, that error in city will be replaced with New Delhi, and wherever sales rep is there, error is there, that will be replaced with Amar. And application I'm just later I'll be replacing null values with Excel. So that is what we are now following. For that I need to make sure that understand the applied steps. So the first applied step is source. So I need to use this source to create the next step. I need not go to the advanced editor again. I can type the code or whatever formula or function within the formula bar. If you don't see the formula bar here, you need to go to the view tab and you need to activate this formula bar option. So check the box. Now let me start writing the second function. That is, I want to clean this city column. That is, I need to replace these errors with a text. For that, it's very simple function I need to add. For that, I'll just click on this FX so that a new window open. So that means a new step is created as custom one. I can rename it as replace error. And then I can start writing the code. So here, I'll be using this as a starting point because my predecessor is source. So I can change that name as well, but anyway, I'm just keeping it as it is. So table dot replace error values. Then, so this is a starting point. Now, if I put a comma, you can see the rest of the information is available there. So you need to give a list, error replacement as list. In that list, so wherever it comes as list, you need to open the curly bracket. So curly bracket, within that I need to write first the table, the column name, where from I need to replace the value, error value, that is city, and what that value to be replaced with error. So currently you have an error. So I'm using a simple logic. So that is nothing but New Delhi. And if I close the bracket, if I press enter, you can see that column is now replaced with New Delhi and no errors are there. So let me go back to the next one. That is another error. There is one more error, that is sales rep. So here also I wanted to use just one value. That is, if say any error is there, please replace Amar there. So same formula I can follow. So let me rather copy this, right? And then let me add a function. Let me replace this value. Only thing is the source will be replaced with replace error, because source is not the predecessor. The predecessor is actually, for this step, the predecessor is replace error. So I just replaced it. Remaining formula is same. Only thing is it is not city now. It is now sales rep. So instead of the city, I need to write sales rep. I need to make sure that names are written properly. And then the name of the sales rep is Amar. Now, if I press enter, you can see now that particular column is placed with a proper value. So now the next one is adding a value to the nulls. So let me replace this with a name. So rename it as replace error one. So that way we have actually achieved three steps. Let me see whether what is happening in the advanced editor. If I go open the advanced editor, you can see the steps are actually created very nicely and the names what you have created here that are there, but currently the last step is replace error one. So anytime you are adding a new error, new step, that step will be added here as whichever is the last step. So that is a system need to be followed. And now we need to replace the nulls. Let me go to the FX button, click on that, and then a new step will be added. There now the predecessor is replace error one. So there I need to add table dot replace value, that is the function, and then open the bracket, comma. Now let us read it. Old value as any. Old value. Old value is what to be replaced with. Here null is the value to be replaced with. So null 1, 2, 3, these are the numbers. These are the values, need not be mentioned with double quotes. So say null. comma, and then new value as any. So what you want to replace with. If you are writing 1, 2, 3, you can just simply put 1, 2, 3, whatever you wanted to put. But in my case, I want to put a text. So within double quotes, Excel, comma. Now I need to use a function, replacer function, that is replacer, replace value. So replacer, replace value, comma. That function will actually allow me to replace null with Excel in a column. So the now I need to give a column name, which column it has to search, and in which column all the row items to be searched, wherever null is there to be replaced. You can see column to search as a list. Wherever the list comes in, you need to open a curly bracket, and there the name of the column is application. And then close the bracket. So the function is table.replaceValue, and then the predecessor, the step which is before step, comma, null, null to be replaced with Excel, so Excel within double quotes, and we are using a function called replacer replace value, and then we are giving a list of columns. So this is only one column, so in other columns that is no such option is there, so I'm just giving the column application. If I press enter, you can see that I think I have not written the typing error. So it is application. Yeah, now you can see that is taken care of. So no errors and no blanks. The next step is creating custom function. That means creating the revenue, fees collected, using the if function, what we have done in the previous videos by using if function in the within the mQuery using the custom column option. First, let me rename the current step. So right click, rename, replace values. And then I need to go to the function key and select it. So this is my previous step. Now I need to create a new step. The new step is table.addColumn. I need to add a new column. And then that should start with replace value, comma. And then let us read the arguments. So new column name, I need to give a text. So as a text, so within double quotes, fees collected, comma. The next is you need to use a function. So column generator. Here I need to look at each row value of the column. That means a duration column. So within that, I need to look at the value, whether the value is whether less than 15 or between 15 to 35 or 35 to 50 or more than 50. This is my rate card. Based on that, I need to create the I'm using an iteration basically. For that, each if. So this is a normal function. So let me do one thing. Let me bring this little down. So each if duration, I need to make sure that the name should be written properly, is less than or equal 15, then 15,000, else again, if duration is greater than 15 and duration is less than or equal 35, then whatever duration multiplied by 900. So let me copy this because same logic I'm using in the below row. So shift enter and paste it. This is 35 and this is 50, and this value will be different. After that, finally I need to say else whatever duration is more than 50 hours should be multiplied by 700. That is not enough, because when I leave this function here, the column will be created with non-recognized value ABC123. So to make sure that it is a number, if I use type number, it will give you a decimal 1.2 sign. Otherwise, if I use integer 64 type, it will give you 123. So that is what I want. So this is the code I have written, and what I have written is table.addColumn, replace values, that is the previous step, and then fees collected is a column name. and then I need to use this each function, and basically iterator. This is iterator which will go inside the column and it will look at each row, and accordingly whatever value is there within the duration column, it is generating the value for me. And if I press enter, you can see now the column is created with the name fees collected, and this is 1, 2, 3, and the values are there. So that way actually we can use many more functions. Hope you understood the steps and code discussed in this video. If you have already watched the previous videos, these steps will make more sense to you. However, you need to practice better to understand the entire methodology what I discussed in this video while using these functions. In the next video, I'm going to discuss about CSV files and SQL database. And then I'm starting with basics, and I'll be discussing many basic points first and then getting into all the functions, and we'll try to understand as much possible Power Query and Power Query Editor. Please keep watching. And for my new videos, to get notified, you need to subscribe if you have not yet subscribed. And if already subscribed, thank you very much. Please share with many, like the video, and spread the word.